Hey guys, it's me, Morgan, here, and I'm back with another YouTube video.
I've been seeing a lot of story times for some reason going on my recommendations feed, so I decided maybe I should do a story time of my own because I have a lot of crazy ones. Today, I've been decided to tell you the story of my disastrous Disney World trip. So, a year ago, we decided that we wanted to go to Orlando just to get away from all the stress in my town because there was a lot of it at the time. And my mom, my dad, and my two sisters, me and my grandma were going, and we were all super, super excited about it. So we decided to do it in like March and April, like mid-April, I think. Yeah, I think it was mid-April, I'm not really sure. But it was like warmer here, but like it was getting warmer in Disney, so we decided the weather is gonna be great, so we should just go for it. My grandma was excited to go because April is our birthday month, so my birthday is April 12th, and my two twin sisters' birthdays are April 3rd, so she was planning a lot of fun things for us to do, and we were all so excited.
Booked everything, and everything was fine. We hopped on a plane and about, like, we decided when we wanted to go in, like, February, and they surprised us in the beginning of March, and we were, like, all freaking out. I don't have a video of it. I wish I did because it was insane.
So we started packing at the end of March, and remember, guys, we were going in mid-April, so, like, we had a lot to pack because we were going for, like, a week and a half, and for us, that's, like, a long time. So we packed, like, our whole wardrobe, basically. It was insane. We had so much stuff. And then we ended up when we got, okay, I'll tell you that part of the story later. It came to be the middle of April, so we were ready to go. We said bye to our dog because she was staying with a dog sitter. And then we went to our airport and we waited for at least 2.5 hours because the plane got delayed or something weird, because it was like 3 in the morning and we were all exhausted and so grumpy and we just didn't want to deal with it. We were hungry, we were tired, we were cranky, we just didn't want to deal with it. Of course, we were so excited to go to Disney World because that's where all the dreams come true apparently, but not this trip. So after 2.5 hours, we decided that we were just gonna go and get something to eat in like the big, you know, the gifts shop. I'll insert a picture here if you don't know what it is. But anyway, we went to the gift shop area. It was closed and it wasn't opening until 4 o'clock. So what if we were already on our plane at 4 o'clock? We wouldn't eat anything, and my mom didn't pack that many snacks because we ate them already. So we were screwed until 4 o'clock. Family has trouble, how should I say this, sitting in like planes or restaurants, sitting next to a certain person, moving, blah, blah, blah. Like, they can't sit still in one spot, or they fight about sitting with a certain person. I do it too. I'm not gonna say I don't. I'm not denying that fact. But we had a big problem with that. My sister wanted to sit with my grandma, but my grandma wanted to sit by herself, and blah, blah, blah. But it ended up working out. We ended up getting on the plane perfectly fine. I don't know how we did it, but it happened. Forgot this part. So we ended up putting all of our bags like in like some in the front of the plane and some in the way back because we had so much stuff. It wouldn't fit in our section, so we had like empty seats in the back, so we just put it back there, but that was insane. It was so bad. I already mentioned my family cannot sit still, and about 1.5 hours into the plane ride, where I live, it's to Orlando, it's about 2.5, maybe 3 hours, so, yeah, so my sister was at all the way at the end, like, say this was the end where you could get up and walk out, and this was my other sister, this was my other sister, so I was here, my sister Lily was here, my sister Callie was here, so Callie was like, I have to go to the bathroom, so she, like, scooted her butt everywhere and like then started walking down the aisle. So then she went to the bathroom. She at least was in there for 15 minutes long. 15 minutes. She was in the bathroom 15 minutes. Because she like ate something weird that day and it was a mess, but it ended up being all right. Finally, after 3 hours, we ended up in Orlando. We were all freaking out. We were so excited, but then we realized we had to take like an Uber, I guess, I don't know, cab to to where we were staying, and it was an extra hour, so we were not happy about that. Guys, we've been up since like 2 o'clock in the morning. We're all tired, hungry, cranky, etc. So we didn't eat, we haven't ate since like 4 probably, and we were just so tired. It was about 8:30 when we arrived, 9 o'clock. So we were in the car and my sister was like, hey, let's go to the bathroom. And we didn't know what to do. We were like, what are we supposed to do? She ended up like complaining the whole time. But then when we got to our hotel, she ran to the bathroom and did her fun things. The few days into the trip, it was like fine. Everything was so much fun. I went on so many fun rides. I went to the pool. It was really fun until, I guess, 3 days into our trip. We went to this Beauty and the Beast dinner, and I am so sorry to anybody who's watching this and is like, how could you spread hate about the Beauty and the Beast dinner in Disney World? I'm not saying like any, I'm not throwing shade to that. I'm just saying that it was not a good experience for us, and we're not gonna be going back there. So we made reservations before we were going on the trip in February. So everything was fine. We sat down. It was like this huge room, and my grandma wanted to sit in the dark room with the rose, like with the big rose thing. But she complained to the people that it was way, way too dark, and she couldn't even see her food. So we had to move into the main area with everybody else. And she was like, it's too loud in here. So we just ended up staying there. We couldn't deal with another moving. Got our drinks, everything's fine. And then we ordered, and I ordered some steak, and I like my meat very, very well done, like completely burnt basically. I know it's gross to some of you medium rare people, but that's just how I like my meat, and that's how my whole family likes their meat. And my mom, she ordered like some muscle thing, whatever. And when the food came, my mom's muscle platter thing came, they were carrying it out, and this like random guy like who worked there was carrying out the muscle platter. And then when he was walking to give it to her, I guess he like stumbled a little bit, and my mom got a new dress at the hotel that day. She was wearing it, it was fresh, it was a new dress, and it spilled all over her new dress. She was furious. My grandma was flipping out. We were all laughing, me and my sisters, because it was kind of funny to admit. But so my grandma said she needed to speak to the manager, actually. So the manager came over. Keep in mind, this was the first time we were talking to the manager at this dinner that night. There's many more to come, but we didn't know that. So she was like, this is my daughter's new dress. The waiter just spilled it. He didn't even say he's sorry. How could they do this? My mom was yelling at the waiters and the managers. So then the manager said that the guy ended up like he had a disability and he didn't know. He was sorry. And we were like, okay, we let it slide until the next course came out. Steak actually came out, and we were cutting into it to cut it, and it was completely raw. It was pink meat, and it looked burnt on the outside when we cut into it. It was completely pink. We were so mad. It wasn't funny. Actually, smart-minded, film this whole thing. I'm gonna only insert a few clips into this video, but there is footage included, and you will see that at the end of the video. So, we were so mad. They ended up giving us like free fast passes or something. They didn't charge us for the 3 steaks that we got. Nobody ended up eating, like we ended up getting chicken nuggets after that. But that was the end of that. It was, we went on a few rides after our dinner, like after the Beauty and the Beast dinner, with our new fast passes. But that was the end of that story. I hope you guys liked this story time. Make sure to subscribe down below. And I'm gonna be posting more, so make sure to keep your post notifications on, turn that bell on, and comment down below if you liked it or not. I don't really care. And click the like button if you like these types of videos. And I'll see you guys later. Bye!
Dark in there, and you got very mad at me. And you can't get mad at me because this is who I am. And Why is that light shining in my face?
My grandma is going to go and complain to people
does.
Like she always does, as my mom says. She's going
to
go complain.
I need to tell you something. She likes being embarrassing.
No, it's
not. So, because... What? What? What?
It's called going.
The waiter just spilled something on my mom and they didn't even look. More drama.
That's a brand new dress I just ordered today at the Christmas store. Where's the napkin? He dumped the whole thing on him.
You just spilled all the muscle for her big dress.
I'm sorry.
You just spilled the entire muscle for her dress.
My God.
I just bought a new dress for her today at the Christmas store.
Cancel the other steak?
Yeah.
Just
I mean, I don't want you to waste it. Yeah.
Yeah, just keep that one. I'll take the other two.
Thank you.
Am I right?
Hi, guys. So, this meal's been pretty interesting. The waiter spilled mussels all over my mom's new dress. Wait. The beast wasn't coming or something? And one more thing. One more thing that I will never forgive this place for. Here we go. Look at this meat. We like our meat really, really well done. Does that look well done to you? Does that look well done to you?
And she added too.
Yeah.
I'm like so disgusted.
Does that look well done? It doesn't. That's like.